Good morning, students. In the earlier video, we had seen about mass and weight and derived the equation for freely falling body as well as if the body is thrown vertically upward. Moving on further, our next topic is weight of an object on the moon. The weight of an object on the moon is the force with which the moon attracts the object. The mass of the moon is less than that of the earth. Due to this, the moon exerts lesser force of attraction on objects. Let mass of the object be small m. Let its weight on the moon be wm. Let the mass of the moon be mm and its radius be rm. Applying universal law of gravitation, the weight of the object on the moon will be Wm equal to capital G mm into small m upon rm squared. Good equation number one. Let the weight of the same object on the earth be We. The mass of the earth is capital M and its radius is capital R. So we get the equation We equal to capital G into capital M into small m upon R square. Now substituting the magnitudes of the mass of the moon, the radius of the moon in the first equation, we get as weight of the moon equal to 7.36 into 10 raised to 22 kg into small m into capital G upon 1.746 into 10 raised to 6 meter the whole square. If we calculate it, it turns out to be 2.431 into 10 raised to 10 capital G into m. Give equation number 3. Now weight of the person on the earth is equal to 5.98 into 10 raised to 24 kg, that is the mass of the earth, into small m into capital G upon radius of the earth is 6.37 into 10 raised to 6 meter the whole square, which on calculating gives us 1.474 into 10 raised to 11 capital G into m small m. Give equation number 4. Dividing equation 3 by equation 4, that is Wm upon We, that is 2.431 into 10 raised to 10 upon 1.474 into 10 raised to 11. It turns out to be in point as 0.165, whereas in fraction as 1 by 6. That is, weight of a person on the moon upon weight of the person on the earth is 1 by 6. So weight of the person or an object is 1 by 6 times the weight of the person on the earth. So we will just recall this concept one more time because it is important for the chapter. The weight of an object on the motion is the force with which the moon attracts the object. The mass of the moon is less than that of the earth. Due to this, moon exerts lesser force of attraction on objects. Let mass of the object be small m. Let its weight on the moon be Wm. Let the mass of the moon be m small n and radius be Rm. Applying universal law of gravitation, the weight of the object on the moon, that is Wm equal to capital G m small n into small m upon Rm the whole square. Give equation number 1. Let the weight of the same object on the earth be We. The mass of the earth is capital M and its radius is capital R. So we get the equation as weight of the person on the earth equal to capital G into capital M into small m upon R square. Give equation number 2. Now substituting the magnitudes of the mass of the moon, mass of the earth, radius of the moon, and radius of the earth in the formulas, we see first equation, weight of the person on the moon equal to 7.36 into 10 raised to 22 kg into small m into capital G upon 1.74 into 10 raised to 6 meter the whole square. That is 2.431 into 10 raised to 10 capital G into m. That is your third equation. Weight of the person on the earth equal to 5.98 into 10 raised to 24 kg into small m into capital G upon 6.37 into 10 raised to 6 meter the whole square. That is equal to 1.474 into 10 raised to 11 capital G into small m. Give equation number 4. Dividing equation 3 by equation 4, we get weight of the person on the moon upon weight of the person on the earth, that is 2.431 into 10 raised to 10 upon 1.474 into 10 raised to 11. That is equal to 0.165. That is in fraction as 1 by 6. Weight of the person on the moon upon weight of the person on the earth is 1 by 6. So weight of the person on the moon is 1 by 6th time that of the weight of the person on the earth. Now moving on further in this chapter, that is thrust and pressure. So what is thrust? The net force in a particular direction, net force which is applied in a particular direction is called thrust. Its unit is Newton. Pressure, the force acting per unit area in a direction perpendicular to it is called the pressure on the surface. Pressure is symbolized by capital P. Its formula is force upon area. So that is capital P equal to F upon A. From equation 1, we can say that pressure can be increased by reducing the area, whereas pressure can be decreased by increasing the area. The SI unit of pressure is Newton per meter square. In memory of French scientist Pascal, the unit of pressure is also called Pascal, that is in short known as Pa, P capital small a. 1 Pa is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. Just take this concept one more time. Thrust, the net force in a particular direction is called thrust. Its unit is Newton. Pressure, the force acting per unit area in a direction perpendicular to it is called the pressure of the surface. Pressure is symbolized by capital P. The formula of pressure is capital P equal to F upon A, that is pressure equal to force upon area. From the first equation, we can say that pressure can be increased by reducing the area. Pressure can be decreased by increasing the area. The SI unit of pressure is Newton per meter square. In memory of the French scientist Pascal, the unit of the pressure is also called Pascal, in short known as Pa, P capital and small a. 1 Pascal, that is 1 Pa equal to 1 Newton per meter square. Hope all might have understood the concept.